Hi, Internet. Welcome to the Grudge Run YouTube channel. It is Thin Lizzy Thursday, and this week is the audience vote. And look at that, we're doing something off the first album again. So we are doing Remembering Part 1. So what's really interesting is that the computer pulled up Remembering Part 1 and Remembering Part 2 as, like, you know, the options, like, right next to each other. So that was very cool that the computer did that. But we saw that the more popular Remembering, at least in terms of the Thin Lizzy fan base, is Part 1. Spoiler alert, I'm actually partial to Part 2 in that debate. So if I could have voted, I would have voted for Remembering Part 2. So this song, like I said, it's off the first album. It's about 6 minutes long, and it's ironically, I don't remember what it sounds like. It might be one of those where as soon as it starts playing, I'll remember the hooks. But right now, I am completely blanking on it. Once again, Greg does not listen to the first album very much. I really should just listen to that while working this week. So possible playlist for this week is the first album. But I'm going to do something different this video. We're going to do the lyrics before we listen to the song. Get that analysis out of the way so I don't have to pause as much. I still have to do the pauses for copyright, but let's take a look at these lyrics. Remember those golden days we used to walk hand in hand? I was your friend, your fool, your lover, I was your man. Okay, so this is just reminiscing on a past relationship. I can see you then smiling, looking straight at me. You caught me unaware as I blushed. Let's sit beneath this tree. Okay, youthful romance. I can't get over the change in you. I can't get over the change in me. But oh, they're growing apart because they're changing. They're growing up. And I keep on remembering the old days. I keep on remembering the old ways. I can recall you running to a sweet shop. You stopped, bought me something, and you handed it to me. You were my girlfriend then, the first I ever had, the first ever kiss, and the first to make me sad. I can't get over the change in you. I can't get over the change in me. Etc., etc. Oh, yeah, I keep on remembering. I keep on remembering the old days, etc. Your pretty dress with the zip-up back. I used to love you like that. And then sort of repeating of lyrics that we've already gotten. So, all right, so this is very straightforward. I'm remembering that past relationship, and I'm sad that it is not my current relationship, is sort of the thesis of the song, which is, I think, very relatable for a number of reasons, more when you're single. Like, I don't pine over, like, past teenage romances. Like, I'm happy and content with my life. But I can see if you're single, where you're, like, you pine over the past, like, oh, no, what if she was the one and she got away? And, you know, what if I'll never find anyone, you know, who will love me again? And then you just do and it's fine. But the thing is, I can still appreciate art in that headspace, because I can remember being in the headspace myself of when you're, like, pining for that past relationship. So, like, even though it doesn't happen to me anymore, I can still, like, remember what it felt like, call back that emotion, and appreciate the art. In the same way that, like, you know, you watch a movie, and you might not be in that same place in your life as that character, and you might never be in that place in your life again, but you can still, like, relate and have the empathy. So, yeah, pretty straightforward lyrics. So let's dive into the music and see if I remember this one.
Remember those golden days, we used to walk hand in hand. I was your friend, your fool, your lover, I was your man. I can see you then smiling, looking straight at me. You caught me unawares, I blushed. Let's sit beneath this tree. And I can't get over the change.
Yes, more of that young band energy, hashtag young band energy. So, again, the sort of a lot of issues that I have with the first two albums are sort of exemplified here in that, so the verse is fine, but as we build into that chorus, the transition just, it doesn't feel like it's appropriate for the material. It just feels like we just changed it, but it's not really like, well, okay, so I'm being charitable. I can't get over the change in you, you can't get over the change in me, and the music actually changes in that part. And so you've got this sort of soft, tender romance in the verse, and then it builds up to this, like, this weird, like, uncomfortable tension in the chorus. But, like, honestly, like, the riff is kind of ugly there. It's just, like, it's not really a pleasant riff. It's not really a cool riff. It's just, like, yeah, it's not that great of a riff. And I don't care for it that much. It just seems, it's an ugly chord progression. Don't really like it. And it also kind of clashes a bit with the melody. So, not a good musical choice there. The verses were fine. They, you know, were melodically pleasing, captured the emotion well. But it just feels like the, you know, garage band, hey, we're just going to put random parts together and call it a song. And for me, that's not as appealing in terms of songcraft. It definitely feels like the kind of thing where, like, the band was jamming together, and that's what they came up with. But in general, I don't like when bands jam together and write. I tend to like, one of the members of the band goes, writes a song, brings it to the rest of the band, and then they sort of contribute from there. But there's, like, that structure. You know, not always the case, not always the best way to write songs, but it tends to be my preferred method. And this just sounds like guys in a room jamming. And then they're just like, what if we did this part? And rather than be like, but does that part really go well with that last part? Like, they don't go together. This is like, trying to think of a really unpleasant combination. Like peanut butter and feet. Just, you know, not really my style. Don't dig it. Remembering. I can recall you running. And honestly, that wasn't that awesome of a drum fill. I love Brian Downey. He's like my dude, you know, one of my favorite drummers. That drum fill was kind of lame, and yeah, it was just kind of lame. I am tearing into this song. I was expecting to be more positive towards it because I remembered, like, kind of liking this one. Yeah, the way I'm feeling right now is less charitable towards this piece. I can recall you running to a sweet shop. You stopped, bought me something, and you handed it to me. You were my girlfriend then, first that I ever had. First that I ever kissed, and the first to make me sad. Okay, so the lines are actually pretty simplistic and don't have the lyrical je ne sais quoi that Phil normally has. So they seem very blunt. They seem very to the point. They're not quite as poetic as he gets in the future. So, like, the language is very simple. There's not really much colorful metaphor in the piece, so it definitely feels like very youthful in the songwriting, which is funny because it's like, oh, pining for when I was young, when he's actually still very young at this point. So the melody is very good. Phil is actually singing very well, and it's not that the emotion is bad, but it comes off as like simplistic and childish, but it comes off as sincere. So it gets a pass for that. So the music in, like, the transitions comes off as, like, you know, childish and lacking sophistication, and it's not good enough or charming enough to get a pass there. But I think the sincerity of the vocal performance and just the earnestness of the lyrics gives it a pass. So some parts of the, like, you know, the youthful charm is endearing, and then some parts of it just like, you know, what you doing? You'll get there. But, you know, I wanted to give some praise to the vocal because it is quite good. And I can't get over the change in you. clashing so terribly. It's not that each individual part isn't being played well, but just it's not going together. This is a... y'all, keeping it real. Like, you know I love Lizzie. I wouldn't have done this for... How many years has it been? Like 2 years at this point? I wouldn't be doing Thin Lizzy Thursdays for, 2 years if I didn't love Thin Lizzy and if they weren't one of my favorite bands. But this is just... This is a mess. Like, unbiased, being objective, taking my... like, affinity for the band out of it, and my natural inclination to say this is great, as I've done in, 100 other videos, more than 100 videos probably at this point. This is clashing. This isn't actually... There are good parts of the song. Like, the verses are good. The verses are good. And the rest of the song is kind of a train wreck and a mess. And just so it's clear, that's not to say that I'm not recognizing that there are parts of this that are not a train wreck. There are parts of it that are, like, very musically competent and cool. And so it'll be like, oh, wow, that lead is going well with that bass part there. And then, like, Eric will play another lead on top of it that'll clash with his lead, and then it won't work. I think that's what's making this frustrating, is that there are good parts, but this song needs, like, drastic edits. Drastic edits.
Oh, yeah!
Okay, that was awesome. That was a very good transition and a really great vocal there. So that was, you know what? That was so good. I'm going to rewind to it because I have a feeling the next section isn't as good.
I keep on remembering. I keep on remembering.
Yeah, that was great. That was McCartney-esque. That was a very Paul McCartney kind of scream. I dug that.
Keep on remembering. Oh, yeah, yeah. I keep on remembering. Oh, bless. I keep on remembering. I used to love you like that.
Yeah, that was not a good vamp. That just, yeah, that was a little bit Spinal Tap-esque, unfortunately. I know this is before Spinal Tap, but yeah.
Keep on remembering all about you.
Well, you know, I wonder. So there was a time where I was on I did a Thin Lizzy podcast, and I re-listened to the first couple albums, and I looked at them very favorably when I listened to them that time. And I think I might have even been, like, positive towards this song to a degree. And I think it's because I remembered the good parts of it, but I had forgotten the bad parts of it. And unfortunately, like, more than half of the song is the bad part. So you got maybe, like, 2 minutes of good stuff in here, but you got 4 minutes of just, like, kind of clashing stuff that's... Yeah, this is not great. It is... It's not a total disaster, because there are good elements, which I tried to highlight. But overall, I was not much a fan of this, and this is probably one of the weakest Lizzy songs we've done. And you know what? Screw it. We're doing Remembering Part 2, because that's a better song. I had to remember it. So we're going to dive into that. Do that right now. So I'm going to pull up the lyrics for it before we get into it. Remembering Part 2. So this is not off the first album. It's off the New Day EP, which means I've actually got to change the artwork. So let's pull up the artwork for New Day because, again, a better release. So let's take a look here. Pull it up. It is so much bigger, that picture that I have. There we go. Okay, New Day. Love the album cover for New Day. Freaking great. Actually, one of my favorites in the Lizzy catalog. And so this is off that EP. And let's read these lyrics. And I could wait and watch you, see it all unwind, and I could wait and look at you, see you change your mind, and I could even look into your eyes, see them hypnotize. Well, even though I'd enjoyed it, to tell the truth, kid, I've got to leave behind those scenes behind. Here I go into a new day. Here I go into a new way. When you stood in that shady doorway and you winked your wicked eye and I looked at you in wide-eyed wonder, you smiled and said hi, just like you did, woman, with that groovy guy that passed by. Well, even though I adored you, to tell the truth, kid, I've got to leave those scenes behind. Here I got into a new day. Here I go into a new way. I guess I could call you my woman, but freedom I need. So down the road I'll be walking, got to have space. Time and space to breathe. Even though I loved you, to tell the truth, I've got to tell. I enjoyed every moment, but kid, you know darned well I've got to leave. So basically, this is the more optimistic sequel to Remembering, where Phil is like, hey, you know, we had our fling. This girl seems to, like, flirt with all the guys, but he's like, hey, that was cool, but I've got to move on and do different things in my life. I've got to go on my next adventure. Is basically the song, and this is one of the highlights of the Eric Bell era. It, so this came out between the first and second album, and yeah, I need to leave with a good taste in my mouth. So we're doing this song. You're getting a bonus.
Into a new day.
Okay, so basically any complaints that we had with the last song are completely rectified with the far superior sequel. So it's more up-tempo and more upbeat, which doesn't necessarily make it better, but the thing is the guitar hooks, that little riff, is really infectious, really fun. It makes you, like, want to keep listening. The vocal, honestly, isn't as good as the last song. It's got a little bit more grit, it got a little bit less melody, but it's still a good vocal. It's not a bad vocal, but I do think the vocal on the last song was technically superior, being completely unbiased and fair. But because there's nothing that's clashing musically, ultimately, it's superior. So even though that one component from the previous song was superior, all the pieces are working so much better together in this one, which tends to be more what I value as a musician, not just like, wow, this one part was really cool. It's how are these parts all working together as a unit? And so this is great. Phenomenal drum fill by Brian Downey after the chorus. Great, catchy chorus, like very hooky. Yeah, so basically, this is perfect. Yeah, this is freaking great. The vocals are going so well with the music. The little flourishes of timing are actually complemented extremely well. The rhythm is great. I'm loving what Brian Downey's doing on the drums, Phil on the bass, you know, Eric on guitar. Like, everyone is sounding great on this song. That was what a great instrumental section. The build was great. The solo was excellent. I'm actually so glad I decided to do both of these. So I can say it's not that like, oh, he just hates the Eric Bell era. It's just like, look, the songs just weren't as good. This is a better song. It's a much better song. In the comments, let me know what you like better, Remembering Part 1 or Part 2. I know most of you voted for Part 1. Y'all are wrong. Part 2 is better. So much better. Chef's kiss, magnifique. If, you know, I'm being a little bit honest, being completely honest, that song probably could have been trimmed down a hair. It's a little bit repetitive in terms of, like, repeating, you know, the same sort of hooks, but they're really good hooks, so, like, you're not really sick of it by the end of the song. We're just like, yeah, and you're ready to listen to it again afterwards. So this is the kind of song you can play on repeat, not get bored, just because it's so infectious, bouncy, fun. Yeah, I am a fan. I'm a big fan. I love that song. One of my favorites of the Eric Bell era. Really, really excellent. I am of the opinion that New Day is better than the first two albums, because I'm correct. And now comes the part, ladies and gentlemen, where we rank it. Rank both of them, part one and part two. I'm going to put Remembering Part 1 as F rank. I think that the musical parts that did not work together were honestly bad enough to justify moving it down, which is unfortunate because I think the verses are quite good, but I think it is kind of a failure of a song because of how bad the choruses and instrumental sections are. They are quite frankly a mess. But now, where am I going to put Remembering Part 2? The sequel. I'm going to put Remembering Part 2. It's going to be S rank. I'm going to put it just below Angel from the Coast. Did I do that for consistency? Oh, that's a part. There we go. So, part one, F rank. Part two, S rank. Did not know that was how this video was going to go when I started the video. Wasn't planning on reacting to both of them. But yeah, that's my honest take on these songs. I think that part two is far superior. I think part one is a mess. I didn't expect to put it in F rank. I thought, like, well, it's probably going to be, like, a Shades of a Blue Orphanage kind of song, because I remembered it being kind of ballady. So I'm like, okay, it's probably going to be, like, maybe, like, a high C rank. But, no, it's, we have another F rank Thin Lizzy song on the list. Shocking, but, you know, that's how it goes. So definitely curious as to your comments on this one. So comment below your thoughts on both these songs, which one you prefer, and if you agree that New Day is S-Rank, Remembering Part 2 is S-Rank. Yeah, it's kind of the title track of the EP, because even though the song's called Remembering Part 2, the big hook is New Day. So, just let me know which one you like better, whether or not you agree with the assessment that Remembering Part 1 is a total mess. Probably don't. Probably going to get some thumbs downs on this video, but please hit thumbs up for the algorithm. Even if you disagree with me, hit thumbs up, then more people see the videos. That's the video. Stick around. The random song is next. Bye, everyone.